and welcome to our first ever episode of Showcase, a variety show that will bring you dancing, dining, and an edge of your seat game show. We'll be starting tonight's show with a takeout challenge, where our resident chef Lewis will be challenged to make a healthy alternative to ordering in. Something easy and fast that you can make at home. Then we have Rhythm of Life, a new segment that will bring you break dancing like you've never seen it before. Plus, if that wasn't enough, we've got what I think is one of the best new game shows around, Hot Shots. So let's get started with our takeout challenge. To tell us more, here's Hope.
Thank you, Angela, and hello. Poita, we have a show prepared for you. Joining me here today at the Daytona Beach College Kitchen is Lewis Jaunty Jr., a student here at the Culinary Arts School. Thank you for joining us, Lewis.
Thank you, Hope.
So what's the challenge for today?
Well, today I'm going up against a local fast food takeout place. We're trying to see if I can prepare a dish that's healthier, tastier, and cheaper than the competition.
Great. Uh-huh. So what are you going to be making?
Today we're making green Thai curry with chicken.
Oh my gosh, that's my favorite dish.
Seriously? Mm-hmm. Well, hopefully if I do it right, I can teach you to make it by yourself at home.
Great. So can you go through some of the ingredients that you're going to be putting into the dish?
First off, we have coconut milk. That's store-bought, comes in a can. We have curry paste, green Thai curry paste.
Now, did you make the paste yourself or did you buy that from the store as well?
You could make it yourself, but it's more convenient to get it from the store, and the store brand it works just fine.
Okay.
But it's an option, pretty much. After that, we have some bite-sized chicken breast. Mm-hmm. We have fish sauce, which is also store-bought.
What is fish sauce?
It's a fish extract. It gives the essence of the fish. It's more of like for flavor. We could make it ourselves at the time, and it's mm-hmm. it's real fishy. It's fish flavor.
Oh.
We have brown sugar. We have chicken stock, long grain white rice, some fresh bamboo shoots, fresh yellow and red peppers, some fresh Thai basil, and some fresh lime zest.
Great.
And all that comes together to make our dish.
Awesome. So what are some of the benefits of making this dish at home versus buying it from a takeout?
Well, there's numerous benefits, but the main three are for the taste, the quality, and the healthiness of the food, the nutrition. You could easily buy it somewhere else and get it. It might taste as good, but with these wholesome ingredients and you're doing it yourself, it's more hands-on and it'll be a better product overall on all aspects of it.
That's really important. Mm-hmm. Well, I can't wait to get started, but first back to you in the studio, Angela.
Great. Thanks, Hope. So you guys know what you need if you want to cook the dish at home. Get your stuff ready, and in the meantime, we're going to take a quick break. But still to come, we've got the Rhythm of Life. So move that furniture out of the way, because it's sure to have you dancing around your living rooms. See you in a moment. Welcome back to Showcase. In just a few moments, we're going to be starting the takeout challenge. But first, we have a little something a little different for you. Welcome to the Rhythm of Life. Hi everybody, and welcome to the Rhythm of Life. I'm your host, Kira Marie, and we have a very special treat for you tonight. Joining me in the studio are two very exciting guests. Lisa Rubel is a B-girl from back in the day, and Alex Seard is a B-boy from today. Lisa is now a choreographer and a dance teacher, and Alex is into the world of body popping and breakdancing. Joining them are a dance crew from the Flagler School of Dance, and they will be giving us a special performance a little later in the show. But first, Lisa and Alex are going to help us have a special insider's look at where dancing within the hip-hop culture has come from and where it is going. So, Lisa, I'm sure everybody wants to know how you got started dancing.
I started dancing probably when I was around 10 years old. We started with jazz. And then later on, I was dancing in resorts as a choreographer for about 10 years. And currently, I'm dancing at the Flagler School of Dance for about 3 years, doing the breakdancing and hip-hop classes.
What made you decide to be a B-girl instead of, say, a ballerina?
Well, back in the 80s, that's all there was. Breakdancing was huge. It was all over the films. It was breaking one, breaking two. Everybody was doing it. And I loved the music and just the whole social part of it as well, how much everybody got along. It was like really fun to do.
It's just like going out with your friends and just kind of like battling.
Freestyle battling, nice. Yes, exactly.
It's a lot of fun. Mm-hmm. Alex, how long have you been dancing, sweetie?
I started when I was 6, and I just got into it by watching films, you know, movies. I saw, You Got Served was like the really one for me that I was just like, oh, snap, that was good.
So you just started dancing, you didn't have like training, you just kind of watched
this
and was
like,
this is what I want to do.
Yeah, this is like my second actual official class that I have. So I just, like when I was 6 all the way to now, I've just been watching films and trying to learn the moves. Kept practicing and practicing for hours.
Lisa, how do you think dancing has changed from, say, when you were a B-girl to the stuff you teach now? Is it any different? Is it the same?
It's a little bit different in ways that there's more like dancing along with the break dancing. Mm-hmm. Back in the 80s, you were either a popper or like a break dancer.
Right.
If you did both, you were like it. But that's pretty much the most of the difference, I would have to say.
A little bit of like jazz in there, a little bit of other things, a little freestyle.
More personality that everybody's brought into it throughout the years.
Do you encourage your students to show personality in each of their moves?
Absolutely.
Aside from your choreography?
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. That's hip-hop. It's all about your personality, your freedom of doing it. I call it add your flavor.
Your flavor?
Add your flavor.
Yeah. Add your flavor without the art dropping. That works.
Yeah.
Do you get much interest around Flagler for breakdancing and hip-hop?
There's a lot of interest in the younger children, mm-hmm. and this past year we had the advanced classes. We had 18 students in our class.
Wow, that's pretty good for Flagler.
Yes,
it's
yes.
kind of a small little mm-hmm. city. Wow, that's awesome. Do you plan on pursuing this as a career, Alex, or just a hobby, something for fun?
Well, it was for fun. You know, I used to do it when I was in middle school at dances, you know, battle whoever I want to, you know. But like now I got more involved in it, like, and I've been taking like classes. I really enjoy it. So hopefully, you know, I can go pursue my dream and try to be a professional dancer.
I'm sure you can do it. If you were doing it at age 6 and making your own stuff up, I'm sure you can do it there.
Yeah.
Do you have recitals and stuff like that with Flagler School of Dance?
Yes. Yes, we have recitals. I only did one today. I mean, one this year.
One this year?
Yeah.
How long does it take you to prepare for something like that?
A while. Because we have to go from piece by piece from the choreography that the choreographer gives you, and you know it's a team effort. So if somebody doesn't get it, you know you got to go back a little bit. So it takes a little while.
What's the longest rehearsal day you've ever had?
Probably 3 to 4 hours.
Yeah, just drill it in their heads.
Because
right?
the recital routines are about 3 minutes long. So that's a long time, too, for 18 kids on stage to perform.
A lot of complicated. Get mm-hmm. everybody on the same foot at the same time.
Exactly.
Very. Wow. What else? How did you start teaching at Flagler School of Dance?
Well, I got back from working at the resorts as a choreographer and just looking for something to do and start and stay in that dancing, you know, career. And they were looking for a hip-hop instructor, and I said, well, I'll just try it. And I'm just so surprised that breakdancing has come back in 2008.
Yeah.
You know, it's all come back, and
so
it's
you're
so
just
great.
So excited to just
yeah.
teach them. Wow.
You feel young again, you know? Yeah. It's great.
Did you always want to teach, like even when you were a B-girl back in the day, did you want to teach kids and show them everything that you know and pass all that on?
I'm just glad I can do it now, but back then it was just all about being with my friends and just dancing and just having a great time and just freestyling and battling, going to the roller ring, and it was just all that's what we did it all in the roller ring. And you meet some friends and you want to do it together, you want to make up a routine, and you would just throw it. It was just like that.
Do most of your friends breakdance, Alex?
I have some friends, yeah. I have some friends that do breakdance and some friends that want to learn. And you know, they'll be like, oh, can you show me that? And I'm not, you know, a teacher, so I try, but you know. But, like, yeah, I have some friends. We try to get a crew together, but sometimes, you know, that doesn't work out. So I'm just in classes.
Keep doing that. Mm-hmm. Thank you, guys. And that we know a little something about what is behind the dancing, we've got a short video showing us some more prevalent moves and their significance.
Give it to me.
That was pretty awesome. After watching that, I don't think I can wait any longer to see these guys dance full out. DJ, give us a beat. Wow, that was pretty amazing, guys. I'm not gonna lie. That looked really difficult. I have no idea how you guys move your body like that. Is it as difficult as it looks?
No. You wanna try?
You guys wanna try show something? Me a little something?
Yeah.
Okay. Something little.
Something little. Okay. Let's do a six step.
Let's lose these. All right.
Yeah. Let's try a six step. Alex, why don't you take the middle there and you can show her what we're talking about. It's a six step or a shuffle.
Okay.
One, two, three, four, five, six. Let's do a standing up first, okay? Standing up, crossing Ready? Over with your right foot. That's one, step back left, two, open up. Then right arm, left foot over, underneath, and open up.
Kind of like a messed up box step?
Yeah.
Kind of?
Pretty much. A little faster.
All right, a little faster.
Seven, so. Eight. One, two, three, four, five, six.
Okay.
Try it down. Okay. Right. Okay.
Right.
All right.
Same thing. Okay. Same with that leg. You ready?
Okay.
One, two, three, four.
Six.
Whoa, good job.
Wow.
Okay. Right. Let's try this with some music, right?
Okay.
DJ?
Y'all get down, Chuck?
Well, that's all we have time for tonight. I hope you've had a great time at home. I know I've had a lot of fun here in the studio. I'm a little bit tired. I just have time to say thank you to Lisa for joining us and everyone here from the Flagler School of Dance. I hope you've enjoyed yourselves. I've been your host, Kira Marie. Thank you for joining us. Back to you, Angela. All right, you guys gonna, come on, answer me. Do this again.
Wow, they were amazing. Thanks, Kira and the Flagler School of Dance. Okay, it's time to start the takeout challenge. So over to you, Hope.
Welcome back to Daytona Beach College of Culinary Arts. Lewis, are you still feeling confident?
Definitely.
Great.
Let's get started.
I'm gonna go ahead and put the order in.
Well, I'm gonna start preparing the dish.
Hi, I'd like to place an order for delivery. Yes, can I have two portions of your Thai green curry chicken with boiled rice? Thanks. Yeah, can I have that delivered to WCEU Channel 15, 1200 West International Speedway Boulevard, Building 400? Great, thank you. Bye. Okay, our order's in. What are you doing over here?
Well, right here we have the coconut milk, but in the can, it separates, and the creamy part rises to the top, and leaves the liquid on the bottom. So you want to add the creamy part, but save the liquid for later. We'll put that in once the dish is finished.
Okay, awesome.
Once that comes to a boil, I'm going to add the curry paste.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the curry paste consists of green chilies, turmeric, garlic, shrimp paste, and a whole bunch of other stuff that's really hard to find. So you're way better off just buying at the store. Well, if you're an adventurer, you can make it yourself, but I wouldn't go through the hassle.
It sounds a lot easier to just buy it from the store.
So I'm going to let this heat up. It might take about a minute or two. And once it starts boiling, I'm going to add the paste. Let the paste incorporate with that, then let it mix. And once that gets to the proper consistency, I'm going to add the chicken.
Mm-hmm.
But you could use chicken, shrimp, duck, pretty much any type of game you would like, whatever you prefer. But today we're using chicken because it's more convenient. I like chicken.
I like chicken too. You know, there's really nothing more impressive than a man in the kitchen. Boys, take notes.
Wow. Thank you. I'm flattered.
Now, I've always been really intimidated about shopping for food, especially vegetables and fruits. Uh-huh. It's always such a gamble knowing if it's ripe or if it's overripe or how do you know?
Usually the color and the texture.
Mm-hmm.
You would tell if it's bruised or it's dark in certain spots. If it's the smell, there's many ways to know, but thankfully today we managed to get some fresh Thai basil. It's not like regular basil, it's purple. So this is the rare
find. Does it smell?
Actually, it does smell, it smells like basil.
Oh, it does smell, that's good.
Yeah, this is one of the fresher ones. The peppers are, usually peppers, they last long. They stay fresh for a long time.
Whoa, there
Action.
It goes. Well, it looks like we're ready to add the curry, huh?
Yes, it's getting there. Be careful when you're working with cream, though, because you don't really want it to boil. It's very fragile. So I'm going to move off the heat for a little while. Okay, that's why we're ready to add the curry. Put that in there.
Okay. Now, how much curry did you just put into that?
That is a quarter of a cup.
Okay. Into a whole can of the coconut milk?
Yes.
Okay.
Regular coconut milk at the flea market or at the grocery store. Not hard to find.
That is starting to smell so good.
Like, if it starts to bubble up too much or gets too hot, don't be afraid to take it off the pot, off the oven. Like, you'd rather take longer than have it on there and burn it.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty much, it's all about just timing. It's easy. It's real simple.
Okay, great. Angela, you're really missing out over here, but back to you for now.
So it's off and running. And if any of you are looking to impress someone with a fantastic home-cooked meal and would like the recipe, you can email us at channel15@dbc.edu. Time for another break, so grab a snack and a drink, and we'll see you in a few moments. Welcome back to Showcase. Now, before the break, you saw us begin the takeout challenge. So let's see if things are heating up over in the kitchen.
Welcome back, everybody. Louis, what's happening now?
Well, the curry's heated up to the proper consistency. I'm ready to add it to the pan and incorporate the chicken to it. I have the pan heating up. Looks about ready. Just add this. This is that. Whoa. Thank you.
No problem. So how much chicken are you adding?
This is about 2 pieces of chicken breast. Mm-hmm. Approximately about 12 ounces. I'll say 8 to 12 ounces.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So how long do you let that cook for?
About a good minute or two. Once this cooks, mm-hmm. I'm going to add the rest of the ingredients, the chicken stock, the rest of the coconut milk, the sugar, and the fish sauce.
Mm-hmm.
But the chicken takes long to cook, so I add it first and let it start working before I add the other stuff. That stuff is already pre-made.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So let this sit here for a little while and get nice and ready.
Okay, great.
And that's, okay. Just making a regular cup of rice. A cup of rice here, measured out. 1 cup of rice, 2 cups of water. Pretty simple, let it sit for 20 minutes, uncovered. And that is that. I put this here and forget about it. By the time that's done,
mm-hmm.
this will be done. It'll be perfect timing. Yeah, pretty much cooking is mainly all about timing, if you really mm-hmm. want to get down to the bottom of it.
Sweet. Well, that really is smelling good.
Thank you. Well, when I add the fish sauce, it might get a little fishy, but
okay.
it'll taste yummy. Brace yourself. Yeah.
Do you use organic chicken?
I would like to. I prefer it. But it costs more money,
mm-hmm.
and it's harder to find. But yeah, I would like to use organic chicken, but I don't. Right now, this isn't. But you should use organic chicken, folks. Organic is always better. Love your animals. And that's the fish sauce. Ew, smells gross.
Mm-hmm.
And now for the sugar. Look at that. Now, once you add the other ingredients, you let this sit for another minute or two. Let it all incorporate and get together. Once that combines, I'm going to add the rest of the coconut milk that I told you about earlier, and the chicken stock. And we'll let that sit for about 3 or 4 minutes to get to the proper consistency. And I'll probably put it to the side so the rice gets done.
Okay.
Right. Just let this work and cook.
Okay, that seems to be coming along well over there in the kitchen. Now, most of us have said at one time or another we'd like to lose weight or to eat healthier. But with busy schedules, that's easier said than done. The meal we're preparing in our kitchen today is simple and efficient to make, not to mention a lot more affordable. If you compare the cost of a takeout meal along with the delivery charges as well as the tip to the cost of all of the ingredients needed to make today's dish, the cost would be significantly less. And on top of that, many of the items can be used again and again. For those of you trying to lose weight, a calorie-controlled diet along with a suitable exercise regime is important. Women need about 1,100 to 1,600 calories per day, depending on how active they are. Obviously, there should be a lower calorie intake for less active people. Men need about 1,600 to 2,000 calories per day. A fast food meal consisting of a cheeseburger, fries, and a cola has approximately 1,500 calories. This is almost all of your daily caloric needs for one meal alone. The easiest way to control this calorie intake is to monitor what goes into your food, and the easiest way to do that is by preparing it yourself. The way certain types of food are cooked also affects the amount of calories in it. For example, Boiled or poached eggs have a significantly lower calorie count than if they were fried or scrambled. Cheese, which is a common and popular ingredient in many dishes, contains a lot of calories, so if you were to use it when preparing a meal, try using mozzarella, feta, or brie cheese, which all have a lower amount of calories. Baked or grilled white meat, such as chicken, contain fewer calories and are less fattening than red meat, such as beef. Steamed fish is also a healthy option for a great home-cooked meal. Not only is it easy to cook, but it contains very few calories and is high in omega-3 fatty acids, which is important in any diet to reduce cholesterol levels. Why not try it with some steamed vegetables and boiled potatoes? It sounds simple enough. One food group that is very important in a diet is fruit and vegetables. An average daily intake of at least 5 servings a day is an important part of everyone's diet. Fruit is great during the day for a low-calorie snack rather than a bar of chocolate, which contains approximately 226 calories, or a bag of potato chips, which contains approximately 800 calories per 6-ounce bag. Healthy, home-cooked, cheap meals are not confined to evening meals. Why not buy some fresh ingredients in your local supermarket and bring lunch to work with you? A standard ham deli sandwich contains 210 calories, whereas a home-prepared sandwich along with some fresh fruit would contain significantly less calories and cost a lot less. So next time you pick up the phone to order in, think twice because you might be getting more than you bargained for. Well, it's time to check back in with the kitchen to see how our dish is coming along. But don't forget, coming up we have the Hot Shots quiz show. But first, let's go over to the kitchen, and the news is that Hope is actually going to cut something. Let's hope it's not her fingers. Let's take a look.
Take this for you.
Okay.
The whole point of the knife, like, they're shaped with a curve on the bottom. You want to have like a rocking type of motion. Mm-hmm. You don't want to add too much pressure. That's how things get, it's sharp. It should be very gentle, very smooth, very fluid. If it's dull and you're trying to go through it, you're going to slip. It might not make no sense, but a sharper knife is safer, as silly as it sounds.
You're right, that doesn't make sense.
Yeah. So, whatever.
Wow, like, that looks so easy.
You see my chefs. Yes. This takes practice, like anything else in life.
Can I try?
You have good insurance? Go ahead.
Very
also,
funny.
Too, take out what you want to do. Let me prepare this for you.
Okay.
The white stuff is no good. You want to eat that. Mm-hmm. It's useless. It has no taste. It has no flavor.
Oh.
You want to cut that out. There you go. Please don't cut yourself. I will laugh.
Now, how do you do it again? Like a rocking motion?
Like a, yeah, like. Use the bottom of it to.
Oh.
But be gentle. Don't try to force your way through it.
Okay. All right, I'm scared. I'm not going to do it anymore. I'm going to hurt myself.
Okay.
My producers would not be happy. Now, what's the difference between red and yellow and green peppers? Is there really none? Is it just the color, or is there a slight taste difference?
Well, it is a slight taste difference, but not really the color, mainly is the main thing.
Mm-hmm.
But it depends on what type of peppers you have. This, the spiciness also varies too, the heat that the pepper packs. So, but the peppers like these, the bell, they're not really spicy at all. So, like, honestly, the color doesn't really matter just for, like, for instance, like that recipe, like that dish right there looks like a regular dish. But once I add the color to it, add the red and the yellow, I'll make it appear like, makes it stand out a little more.
Wow, you're right. That does look better.
When I add the basil, it will look even different.
Mm-hmm.
But like I said, basil is very sensitive, so I'm going to wait till I add that till the end. That's more for flavoring.
Okay.
Yeah, screw it.
Now, about how much the peppers are you putting in?
I have about 4 ounces of each.
Okay.
But you can do as much as you want. You might like this more than that, or you could use eggplant. You don't have to be peppers either.
And eggplant, really?
Yes. The recipe calls for eggplant, but I know I like peppers, so I'm eating those instead.
Mm-hmm.
But it's up to you. You're at home. You can do what you want. You can add a handful. I'd add none at all.
Great. Experiment.
You have the option at home.
Mm-hmm.
At the restaurant, to try something different. So, another benefit. All right.
Now, when do you add the rest of the ingredients?
The bamboo shoots I could add right now. The remaining ingredients, I add those at the end. The last two ingredients are the lime zest and, hold on a second here. The lime zest and the basil. Those go at the very, very end. When the dish is completely done, then I'm going to add those. Okay. Like I said, because the basil, like I said, it cooks quickly.
Mm-hmm. Wow, that's already making me hungry. Don't forget, if you want to know how to make the same dish, then email us at channel15@dbc.edu. Time for another break, but coming up next, a quiz show that'll have you on the edge of your seat. See you in a moment. Welcome back to Showcase. There are a lot of quiz shows on television these days, but only one is as fast and fierce as Hot Shots. Two teams battle it out for a grand prize of a possible $30,000. Here's Hot Shot.
Hello, my name is Tom Murray, and welcome to our new and exciting game show, Hot Shots. It will fill you with anticipation and bring you to the edge of your seats. Our game consists of two teams that will battle it out for the grand prize of a possible $30,000. Now, each team will start off with a $15,000 in their bank, but they must place bets between $1,000 and $3,000 on questions throughout the show. Now, the team will consist of two members, okay? And one of the members will be considered a team captain, and the other team member will be considered the partner. The team captain is the only one who is allowed to read the final answer. Now, without further ado, let me introduce you to today, our team, Itchy.
Woo!
Well, Team Itchy, would you like to tell the audience a little about yourselves?
I'm Pamela, and I love grilled cheese.
I'm Tracy, and I like macaroni and cheese.
Ladies of many words, I see. Very, very upscale of you. Now, going over to Team Scratchy.
Yeah.
I wonder where you guys came up with your names. Would you like to introduce the audience to yourselves?
I'm Robbie, and I like sports.
Hi, I'm Michelle, and yeah, I like dance.
Wow, we have a lively crowd on the contestant stands. I hope you guys didn't, you know, spend too much on that fancy attire for the game show today. Well, it is a pleasure to have you on the show. In round one, each team will be asked three general knowledge questions, and they must place their bets before each question is asked. And remember, teams, if you get the answer wrong, the money comes out of your bank, and the other team has the chance to steal the money. Let's play Hot Shots. So, Team Itchy, how much would you like to bet on this first question?
You got nothing.
Okay. We haven't even gotten to the questions and we're contemplating.
$2,000, we're a team.
Okay, $2,000, okay. For $2,000, what country is hosting the 2008 Olympic Games?
China.
That is correct. It took you longer to figure out how much you were betting on that. All right. Question two.
I don't know.
How much would you guys like to bet on this question?
Okay.
$1,000.
All right, for $1,000. What 2007 convicted celebrity drunkard is named Ligilo?
Go for it.
John Travolta?
Not even close. Let's go over to Team Scratchy. For $1,000, can you tell me which celebrity drunkard in 2007 was nicknamed Lilo?
Lindsay Lohan?
Correct. Shocked even me. All right then, going back to Team Itchy, how much would you guys like to bet on your final question?
$1,000.
All right, for a whole $1,000. What star sign are people born on the 25th of August?
Libra?
I'm sorry, that's not the answer we're looking for. Let's go over back over to Team Scratchy.
Yeah.
What star sign are people who are born on the 25th of August?
Leo.
The answer was Virgo.
Oh.
And let's go over to Team Scratchy. How much would you like to bet on your first question?
What's up? Okay, two.
Two?
Yeah.
You have to bet between a grand and
$2,000.
Okay. For a whole $2. In which USA city was the 2006 Super Bowl held?
Detroit?
Correct. All right, then. Apparently liking sports is paying off. All right. Question two, how much would you like to bet?
$3,000.
All right, for $3,000, who is the voice of Marty the Zebra in the 2005 film Madagascar?
Marty is the... He's the zebra?
He is the zebra.
Okay, it's the zebra. Okay, Chris Rock.
Correct. I'd like to remind the audience that we did not find these students at Harvard. Question three. How much would you like to bet?
$3,000.
All right, for $3,000. What is the name of the poker hand? Three of a kind and a pair.
Full house.
Full house is correct. And that concludes round one. All right, going to round two. I hope you enjoyed that round. Well, Team Itchy, gonna have to catch up. I guess miracles happen every day. For this next round, it'll be a round of musical questions. You'll hear two pieces of music being played for each team, and we want the name of the song. Remember, place your bets according to your musical knowledge.
Are you good at music?
Okay, Team Itchy, how much would you like to bet?
$1,000.
Finally, someone takes my advice. All right, can you name this song? Well, we're gonna name, we need a name.
Is it just the name of the song?
Just the name of the song.
Don't forget time.
Sorry, that's incorrect. Going over to Team Scratchy. Any ideas?
The answer is
Time up. The answer is not The answer we were looking for was Thinking of You. All right, back to Team Itchy. What would you like to wager on this next song?
1,000.
2,000.
All right. I see some betrayal starting. For $2,000, can you name this song?
Taking Control?
Can we accept that answer? The answer is Take Control. You are correct. All right, over to Team Scratchy. Okay, for your first musical question, what would you like to bet?
$1,000.
Okay, for $1,000, can you name this song?
Is the answer Respect Yourself?
Correct. That even caught me a little off guard. All right. For your second question, how much would you like to bet?
Three. Go for it. Three. Yep.
All right. For $3,000, can you name this song?
That's all you get?
That's all you get.
Darn it. Chorus is about to come out. All right, what is it?
You guys got to... Come on, guys.
Say anyway?
No, but...
What? Anyway. Anyway.
The answer is anyway. You are correct.
All right.
Okay. Itchy on my right has $16,000.
Woo.
Scratchy has $27,000.
Yeah.
All right, teams, it's now time for the quickfire round. We have Barry Donnelly now to ask you a question, and the team with the closest answer that is correct will get first choice from two mystery boxes that give them the chance to add to their prize money.
Yeah.
Me, I get to go backstage, and I don't have to put up with you for the next couple of minutes, so we all win. Here's the question.
Darn.
Oh, hello, guys. How are you? Beautiful day for barbecue, don't you think? My name's Barry Donnelly.
and I have a question for you. My question is, how many degrees in Fahrenheit does it take to turn a book to ice?
All right, and we're back.
He was talking, I couldn't hear
him. Now, you guys have the highest number. The question again is, how many degrees in Fahrenheit does it take to turn a book to ash, in case you weren't paying attention again?
Okay.
We're looking for the closest answer of the two of you.
I would say 120, 130 degrees.
We're going to need an answer, guys. Come on.
200 degrees Fahrenheit.
All right, 200 degrees Fahrenheit. And before we find the answer to that question, let's come over to Team Itchy. Team Itchy, any ideas?
120 degrees Fahrenheit.
120 degrees Fahrenheit. So just to recap, you guys said 200 and you said 120 degrees. The answer was 451 degrees. Therefore, Scratchy gets first choice of the boxes. Now, we have two glorious boxes here for you. You get first choice. Would you like the large, magnificent looking one or two? One.
We don't want him, so we'll take two.
Yeah, whatever. And here's the glorious box number one.
Can we open it?
No, don't open them. Oh, set them down at your feet.
Hi.
Pretend you're Indiana Jones. You open the box, your face melts, okay? Let's all pretend here. Okay, teams, the moment of truth has arrived. Now that the anticipation is built, you can pick up your boxes again.
Wow.
And on the count of five, please open the boxes to find out what you have won.
Wait, it's over? Okay.
You guys can't count to five?
Wait.
Somebody count to five.
Wait a minute.
One, two, three, four, five.
Open your boxes.
Oh.
I have to help people out with everything now, dude.
Oh.
And let's see what you got.
All right.
All right. Now, that means you win the first chance to gamble in our final round for all the money in the game. It all lies on the final question.
I love gambling.
However, you have an opportunity in this round. Okay, since you're the team captain who got the box that says you won, I'm giving you the opportunity to get rid of dead weight and switch for that teammate. Someone who would pull their own weight for once. I see
you. I answered a question.
I see what you're doing, trying to freeload off of him, you know. So we're going to need your answer. Would you like that teammate right there? I've seen her answer every question.
She seems a little sketchy. I'm going to stick with my girl here.
She's going to, okay.
Oh, yeah.
I am sketchy.
I have a feeling you'll regret that later.
I thought you got Tracy.
Okay, guys.
I thought it was. Oh, okay.
Well, it's good for being loyal to your teammate, but I would have ditched her.
Thanks.
I'm sorry, I'm more about the money. It's time for the moment of truth. Are you going to win the grand prize or leave here with nothing? Here is the final question. In which year did the Titanic sink?
1912.
And they are correct. Well done, team. Bad luck, guys.
Yeah.
Sorry about that.
Oh, well, never.
You just weren't smart enough.
Everyone.
Well, thank you all for playing tonight. Now, that brings your grand total to $27,000.
Okay.
And that brings your grand total to cleaning up after we're done here.
I know.
Well, I hope you enjoyed the show as much as I did. And make sure to join us again from all of us here at Hot Shots.
Oh, my God.
Over to you, Angela.
Thanks, Tom. Man, I love that game. All the way from the heat of the kitchen, Hope has joined us in the studio as we anxiously wait to see if Lewis can beat our takeout challenge. Thanks for joining us, Hope.
No problem, Angela.
So how did it go in the kitchen?
It went really well.
Really? Mm-hmm. No broken bones or cuts or anything?
No, I have all my fingers.
Good. See? That makes me feel better. So how long would you say it took to prepare the meal from start to finish?
Probably less than half an hour.
Really?
Yeah, I went by really fast.
Wow, you can't get takeout in half an hour.
Not at all.
No. Wow. So, okay. As a regular person that's not a trained chef like Lewis is, do you think you could make it at home without his help?
Probably. It would take a little bit more time and a little bit more patience, but I think I could pull it off.
Really? Mm-hmm. Good. Okay. All right, why don't we jump over to the kitchen and see how Lewis is doing?
How you doing, guys? All right, we got the rice ready and boxed up. And packaged up this curry, and it'll be all done. Looks great. Smells good. And we are finished. Get this lid on. There we go. And that's that. We're all done over here. Like, oh, I'm sorry.
So word is Lewis is on his way. Why don't we get our other hosts, Kira and Tom, to join us so they can taste this yummy food that he's about to bring us. Because I know I'm hungry, and I know you guys must be, especially after your Rhythm of Life dancing and your tough hotshot hosting.
I'm so excited. I'm so hungry. Aww. I know.
I can't wait for you guys to try this. It smelled so good while it was cooking.
Aww. Okay, okay, word is Lewis is outside. Yep, okay, here he comes. Oh, great, okay, I'm excited. He better hurry. He's running out of time. Clock's ticking.
Oh,
I'm really hungry. I think my stomach just growled.
Okay, he's almost here. Oh, come on, hurry. Beat the delivery guy. Let's see. There he is. Welcome, Lewis.
Sorry for the wait, ladies.
No, you made it actually in time. Okay. That's great. I'm
Everything
so excited.
Everything is still steaming hot.
Good. We're all very hungry. We haven't eaten all day.
Wait until you smell the curry.
Oh my God, that smells amazing.
Thank you, thank you.
I can't wait
Let's
to
see how
it
tastes.
Okay. This looks so yummy. grab a fork. Yeah, get ready.
Hold on.
Oh, thank
rice
you.
For you.
This rice looks amazing. It's so fluffy. I can
That was the easy part.
You know?
Okay.
Okay.
And now for the goodies.
The good stuff. Let's taste it.
This is our green Thai curry with chicken. Uh-huh. Something for you. And a little bit for you.
Wow. What else in there?
We have some bamboo shoots, fresh red and yellow peppers, some chicken. We have some curry paste.
Oh, wow.
We
Let's
have
try this. Let's see.
Chicken broth.
Oh, my God.
And some
coconut. Oh, my God. That's amazing.
Thank you. I'm flattered.
Wow. Okay. Somebody needs to tell the delivery guy that he lost. Game over. This is so amazing. And it only took, what, 30 minutes to make?
Less than 30. About 25 minutes.
That's great.
And have enough leftover ingredients to make it again probably next week or tomorrow.
That's such a great thing. See?
So yes,
who needs takeout?
Cheaper, faster, and better.
I mean, really. Okay. That really, thank you so much.
Thank
it's
you.
Amazing.
I'm so flattered.
It's very amazing.
Anytime. I love
thank
it.
You.
Glad you liked it.
Okay. So there's only one thing left for me to do, and that's thank all of our guests on tonight's show and our hosts, Kira and Rhythm of Life and the Flagler School of Dance, and Hope and Lewis. And Tom and the Hot Shots team, thank you guys so much. We couldn't have done it without all of you. Okay, well, I'm Angela, your host. We'll see you next week. Bye-bye.